Hello, good afternoon everyone. I welcome you all. In today's session, we will see the introductory part regarding instrumental methods of chemical analysis. So, before going into details about the instrumental methods of chemical analysis, we should know some basic terms. So, the chemical analysis. What is meant by chemical analysis? Analysis means investigation. To study. So what to study? So chemical analysis is of two types. One is qualitative analysis and other is quantitative analysis. What is meant by qualitative? Where we measure the quality. What is quality? Quality is nothing but content or composition. So that we call it as qualitative analysis. While what is quantitative analysis? Where we measure the quantity or the amount that measures in the quantitative analysis. The quantitative analysis is of two types. One is volumetry and other is gravimetry. So volumetry is one where we measure the volumes and gravimetry is one where we measure the masses, right? There are so many advantages of instrumental methods of chemical analysis, but we will not take much time on this. In this session, I will just explain you the difference between equivalence point and end point of the titration. So as we know, the traditional titration and instrumental titrations we have to see. In 11th and 12th class, you might have studied various types of titrations. So whenever we see the titration, you know that we need a burette, right? So you need a burette, some conical flask. While in instrumental method, actually we require these few parameters as a basic parameters, but here we require some instrument. Here you can see, okay? So these solutions, let us consider NaOH solution is taken in the burette and HCl solution is taken in the conical flask. So in both the cases, whether it is instrumental method or it is traditional method, my solutions are same, just there is a difference that here we require some instrument and here we don't need to use any indicator. Any indicator is not required. So let us see the traditional titration, what we do. So when we are performing the titration, you take burette, pipette, some solution in the conical flask, pipette out solution in the conical flask. So let us see the difference between end point and equivalence point. So let us consider 10 ml of HCl solution is taken in the conical flask. Okay, you can see the various molecules. Let us consider 10 molecules of HCl we have taken. And when we are adding indicator into this and we are adding burette solution, then what happens? Why and when we can observe the end point? So when you are adding the first drop or first molecule from the burette, what you will find? That there will be reaction, there will be neutralization reaction and that will disappear. When next molecule will be added, that will react. It means in this way, the number of molecules which are taken in the beaker or in the burette, that will disappear, that will react with the burette solution, right? It means one stage will reach at which there is no any molecule of conical flask solution in the conical flask. So as this is the last molecule, when this molecule is getting finished, now what will happen? Actually, this should be the titration completion point or reaction completion point, but we cannot see it. Why we cannot see it? The reason is we cannot see the color change and we have the habit of observing the color because we are using indicator, we are not using instrument. So when color change will be observed, actually we don't know this reaction is over or not. We cannot see the molecules. So when we are adding next molecule of burette solution and there is no any conical flask molecule or HCl molecule to react, so that will react with the indicator and the solution will appear pink. It means you stop at this particular point and you say that end point is reached. So this is the difference, main difference between equivalence point and end point. Okay, so this is the end point and just few drops before or one drop before, whatever the reaction completion point was there, that is actually the equivalence point. So equivalence point is not possible to be determined by traditional way, by traditional titration. So we are using instruments and instrumental methods. So by using instrumental method, we can perform we can identify the equivalence point. So that's it for today. Thank you.